an uncle. This is one of my favorite kata, but I've got to say that much like the Zen story of the monk who goes to the butcher and says, "Give me your best cut." And the butcher thinks for a minute and says, "Sir, every cut." You have two opponents on the 45. They're coming in near concurrent timing. You're going to use a preemptive block to actually, as an attack, to break the arm. So as the first man steps in, you attack behind the elbow and break the arm. That's the only reason you can turn to the second one and do the same. If the arm doesn't break, you have to switch to a different opponent, but then come quickly back to the first opponent, punching them to soften. They grab your hand, and you're trying to pull away, but they just slide up your hand and go to choke you. You bring your hands up and inside their arms, separating them in a Sanchin Dachi for stability, box the ears, which is a hidden movement, pull back, do a double inside punch, adjust the distancing, and do a finishing blow to the xiphoid process. Here's the opening of the kata ananko done a little bit faster. The two opponents have flared out on your sides. Here's an application from a little bit deeper into the kata. Once again, you have two opponents, front and back. As the one from the front comes in, you block their punch, you pull it into you, and use your elbow smash and a shikawashi to attack them. Almost immediately, the other attacker comes with a kick, which you deflect. As you go in to punch them, they back up and block. As they come back to counter you, you back up and block. Now you slide in to adjust distance, you kick. The down block could be a strike to the groin, a punch to the midsection, and a strike to the face. Again, thinking of blocks as strikes sometimes will change your perspective of the bunkai.